Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about Java 8's new time API, time and date API. And these features are really nice and a really big improvement to Java 8. So if you haven't heard about this, then follow along. First off, Java 7 and the ones before had a really convoluted structure where you put all your date clauses. First off, we had some formatting things that were added to Java text. Well, you could think that, okay, Java text is something that has to do with strings, so might be some parsing functions that should be in there. And then we have the util clauses, where we have a lot of different other stuff, but we also have dates, and we have calendars, dates, locales. And then we have another package called Java SQL, which also has a date. And if we go down to the code here, we have the first one. We create a date, new date, and that will actually give us the day, current time. Which isn't actually really intuitive. You don't really say that I want now or a date representing the current time. You just say I want a new date and you get a date representing the current time. And to initialize this SQL date, you give it a long value of the current time, and it will create this date value, and that date value is the current date, not the current date time. So the first one was actually current date time, so you got both the date and the time in the same object, and you can manipulate it like that. And then we have this simple date format, a very nice function to actually handle your dates and reformat them. And to do a reformatting, you put in your format over here, and then you do a print out to see that formatting. And in order to parse, you actually have to put it in a try catch block, because this could actually fail and throw an exception. And another thing that I found here was that if I this date I set here, that should be in CEST, when it comes to the date, it's actually saved in Central European time, not Central European Standard Time. So the problem here is that I actually get 2330 the year before. So this is a little bit weird that it actually changes up the current date information inside of the format. Then we have this date format function, where I could create a new date instance with the format of full. And this is, if I look at the documentation, what this actually would entail, it doesn't really give you that result if you say full. So even documentation doesn't know what that actually entails. And I will type it out in the locale of simplified Chinese. And another thing that we have to do or had to do was, when we are adding a day to a date, we created a calendar, we set the day to that calendar, we added a day of a month to that calendar object and got a date object back. And if we were then wanted to add a month, an extra month to this day, we set the day again and then add the month and get the date object back again. So there was a lot of things in the old API and the old way of doing things that was not that intuitive and quite strange. I'm not sure if you can see the run data here. The problem I talked about earlier here, I get Sunday, December 28th, even 23:30 CET 2014. So that's not even close to the date that I actually set in my parsing. So, that's a bit weird. So let's go into the new API and talk a little bit about how to do these things and more in this API. So the first thing we wanted to do was get the local date time now. And you just create a local date time, I call it D1, and the local date time, I get the instance of now. So I just run the static function now and I get this D1 back. And if I want a local date, it's called local date D1 now. So I will get a date, which is the current actual date. And later we have this simple date format. We wanted to put out a full date with the time zone and so on. And this was something that actually bit me, that I wasn't able to print out the time zone because I hadn't actually supplied the time zone to the local date object. So in order to actually print out with the time zone, I was required to create a zoned date time, D3, and create this of a D1 and set it to a zone ID system default. You could choose another zone ID here if you want to say that the date is in another format. And then I create this date time formatter, and I can actually run my D3, the new date here, run the format function on that with a simple date. And I get back the result of this formatting. Another way we can do this is when we come down to this full date Chinese locale. So this I've called the Chinese date. And here I create a daytime formatter of a pattern, and this is the actual pattern, or this up here is what the documentation says that the full shall print out. So I looked into the documentation and created a pattern that will print that, so that it looks like this. And to write it out in a Chinese locale, I just with locale Chinese, and I do a print of that. So that's quite simple to print something in another locale if you want to make something translated. And I want to add a day, so I system out D1 plus a day. Nothing hard there. And I wanted to add a month, and in this case, there is actually a plus month, but I wanted to show that you can actually use this krona unit and get months from there. So you can plus an amount to add with the unit. If you want to do it like that instead, might have some logic where you need to add some amount of something and you want to choose the amount of some place and the unit somewhere else. Then this could be a nice way to fix that issue for you. And then I have this small little function here which queries the current date and checks if it's a weekend. And here I use a little function that I have created further down. So you can look at that little function. It gets a temporal accessor, which is a date, and it will return a boolean. I just get the day of the week and check if it's either 6 or 7, which are the last days of the week, and return true or return false. And these might be different depending on your region. Some earlier they actually counted that Sundays were zero and six were Saturdays. I'm not sure if the current API doesn't allow that, so you always get 6-7, or if there is some setting somewhere, or if different locales give different results. But for this, I just wanted to show you how the query functionality worked. So this is not production ready code, it's just to show the functionality. And next thing we have here is the instant API. It's a very nice little addition where you have separated the date functionality and the date API things, where you actually are handling date and date data and have a intelligent calculation that actually takes care of leap seconds and of leap years and everything around that, and it works with the real date. With this instant, you actually are using a simpler format. It's just a timestamp and it's pretty much in milliseconds, so you can set it an instant now and then do calculations more in the realm of seconds and milliseconds, and you don't really care about when it actually changes between different dates. So you are not really working with dates, you just wanted to see something. And then a thing that you can use this with is the duration. And the duration is a thing that you actually are saving some metadata that says that I mean this chunk of time. So if I say a duration of 10 seconds, it will actually interpret to something that says, okay, this is between this amount, it's this amount of time. So you can use it with instance and say that my start position is here and I want to see if I'm in the duration of 10 seconds. You can also use durations with the standard date API and just plus the duration as I do here. So I plus the 10 seconds to my first date, just to show that you can use it with the plus operator as well. And lastly, I wanted to do some little fun things with this API. So I created a local date today, now. And then I created this birthday variable, set it to the year of 1979, month of April, day, the first day of that month. And then I created a period between the birthday and today. And I asked this period, how many days are it between the birthday and today? And I also checked the periods, how many years are there? How many months are there? How many days are there? And how many days are there total? So if I run this, I get the different results here. If you have a large screen, you might be able to read this. So the first format here is a little bit different than the other format that we saw, but it's a representation of a full date in an ISO standard. And then we have a simple date, a date and time, the first one. And then we have my formatting here, and then we have this strange format in Chinese, this full format that I've just read from the documentation and used. I can't read Chinese, but I guess it says Sunday there. And then we have these where I add one day and later add one month. And you can see here that the first one I had add one day, and it doesn't change the current value. It just adds a day and returns the new immutable object. So the second one, we can actually add a month and we will keep the current day. And then it checks, and it's actually Sunday today, so that's true. And we are writing out this current timestamp, and the gap here we added 10 seconds, so that's the next to last. And if you are have a birthday on the 1st of April 1997, then you are 38 years old, 4 months, 12 days, and that's 14 days in total. This is what I wanted to show with this API. There is a lot of nice things done under the hood. Before, these classes were mutable and not thread safe. Now they are immutable and thread safe. So they have done a lot of work behind the scenes to actually make this API much easier to work with and much safer and better. So if you haven't used it yet, then why not give it a try? I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that you learned something today. If you haven't subscribed yet and think that these kind of videos are interesting, then please subscribe. I'm very much appreciated of that. And if you have any questions at all, please give me a comment, or if you have any suggestions or changes that you want me to make, or things that you think I've missed in this video, then please tell me, and I really hope to see you in the next one.